Conscious Souls. Welcome to Joyful Living. We have such a cool show for you today, and I'm so excited to welcome one of my dearest friends, Kelly King Anderson, who is here to just kick off the new year strong and help us set some really powerful intentions and get clear. I'm getting chills as even I'm saying this, so I know it's going to be such a good episode. But let me, before we bring her in, tell you a little bit about Kelly. Now, first of all, she has been in the show on the show in the past, and so we will link to that past episode in the show notes if you want to check that out. It was amazing. And then, you know, she's here now, and there's so much growth that's happened in between. So Kelly is an incredible business and life coach. I mean, overall, you just coach on everything. You're incredible. And a big believer of people. And she loves to help people to create their dreams, which is so true. I see her do this all the time, every day. She's one of the top leaders in the doTERRA organization. If you guys have heard of doTERRA, it's incredible. And I play in doTERRA with her as well. And it's so great. Kelly is also an author, and she leads a beautiful Facebook community. If any of you guys are curious about connecting with her more deeply, called Creating with God. And it's on Facebook. It's such an inspiring place, and it might really resonate with a lot of you. But she definitely is a big world traveler all the time, and seizing the day and her dreams that way, as well as leading her international business organization and just really blessing and seeking to serve in so many ways. That she's just a really inspiring person. So without further ado, Kelly, welcome to the show officially.
Thank you so much, Quinn, for being here. This is one of my favorite topics, so we're going to have a great time talking about it and sharing with everyone.
Oh, man. Me too. I'm so excited. And so maybe let's give a little bit of background. Well, first of all, so Kelly and I are really good friends, as I mentioned. And we, I think that, you know, even within the community, our mutual communities that we're a part of, we still are kind of those wild cards a little bit, in that we really are like, oh, that's a big dream, let's just go for it. Or, oh, that's a fun place in the world, let's just go there together. Yep. And so, as you're hearing this conversation with Kelly, I want you to keep that in mind, that anything that we're sharing is not shared from a space of like head knowledge. This is really like heart and soul and experience knowledge of what has really worked to change both of our lives and to really create more intentionally in our lives and our businesses and our families, and just open up our worlds in a whole bigger way. So I wonder if you wouldn't mind giving a little bit of background about the concept and how we're going to play with
it. Okay. So we'll just have some fun here for a minute. So a lot of you are probably so used to making an annual New Year's resolution. And we threw that out the window about 10 years ago, and we don't do that anymore. What we do is we create with an intention, and we pick a word. It also could be a theme, but for us, it's usually centered around a word. And Quinn has joined me in this practice for at least, I would say, 8 to 10 years. I don't even know when it started, really. Who knows? But it's just been such a joyful practice. And it's also something that it's like, ooh, what's my word going to be? It's kind of like getting a new journal and wondering what the pages are going to be filled with, right? But in this case, it's your year, your calendar. And so what is your calendar going to be filled with? And you get to decide why choosing this theme or intention, right? So as we talk today, just have an open mind and possibility that maybe this year, 2018, is going to be your best year yet. And you're going to, you know, experience, you know, more excitement, more growth, more opportunity, more, you know, lovely, beautiful experiences because of what you're going to decide in the next couple of days. Because you don't want to overthink it, but you need to, we're inviting you to choose in a beautiful way. And for me, I just like to, you know, just receive this word. I don't try and overthink it too much. And just, what is it, universe, God, tell me. And it just kind of comes, or in sometimes unexpected ways. But we can talk more about the process later. But that's kind of what we're inviting you to do. So if you're in for it and you're think that this sounds fun, maybe you've done it before, that's what we're talking about today.
I love it. It's so good. And one of the cool things about it is it really helps you have a really powerful reframe in your mind. Like I was just thinking before I did this practice, like you said, who knows how long, but it was kind of like the new year would just come and you'd just be thinking, okay, well, I hope this is better than the last and I want to do these things, right? But it wasn't really like that intention or hope for the year was really anchored to anything except for just like a random hope. And so in past years, it was really hard to have those things actually happen, right? And so that's the biggest, I love that word in connection with what we're talking about today, that this is an anchor. This mm-hmm. keeps your heart and soul anchored to your path and to yeah. your lessons, your, you know, all your dreams even, right?
Yeah. Also in the past, we've used words like compass and North Star. And those are beautiful words too, in addition to anchor, because the anchor like grounds you, right? And it keeps you like focused. But then the North Star concept or compass is like where you're headed, right? So it's almost both. I would say it's anchoring and North Star like, because we know where we want to go because of the word we chose. And it's really fun for me because we often bring up this topic, you know, on Facebook and people start sharing what their words are. And then I like to check in with people throughout the year and like, well, how has it affected you? Or, you know, what differences have you found or experiences? And should we just go into our 2016?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So, I was thinking too, like maybe actually let's talk about the process first.
So okay. 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 Let's do that first. Well, what's this process like for you, Quinn?
Well, I was thinking in the beginning, I think that this process starts a little bit more mechanically. Like I know when my first word I think I chose was abundance. You'd probably remember because I think you cemented it in a bracelet for me, you beautiful soul. But something like that. But it wasn't like it wasn't as much like a connection with the divine kind of a piece. It was a little bit, but it was also just like, man, there's a lot of pain in my world around scarcity and not having enough that I desire something different. Mm. I desire a different experience next year. So I'm going to anchor myself to that word. Mm. But then as it's evolved, and I see a lot of people do this where they're just kind of acting from their pain.
Yeah.
Like, oh, I want the opposite. So that's the word, right? But then I think as you get into it and you evolve, it becomes such a spiritual practice, right?
It does. Yeah.
So maybe if you want to,
for me, like I agree with Quinn, like at first it probably does start like that for most people. Like, what do I want to stop experiencing in my life? You know, and that's fine. But if you are a faith person, what I like to do is I like to just, you know, surrender it to God and recognize that I might not love the word, you know, I might not love it yet, but I will love that word. And so a couple experiences I've had with that is just even just praying at night, like, you know, God, I'm ready to receive my word for 2018. And then in the morning, like the word is on the top of my tongue or something. Or it could be as simple as, what am I drawn to? And then just comes, right? Or it could take longer, but excuse me. But the point that I'm inviting is don't overdo it. Like, don't be like, you know, write a list of 25 name words and then circle the ones you're most drawn to. Just allow the word just to come, you know? And because I think that that's, you know the word. Like, you just do. Trust yourself. And one time I had the word love twice. And I was a little bit disappointed. I was like, wait, I already did that word. and God was like, no, like, this is a great word. You know, let's do it again. And it was true that you will learn different things. So even if I chose love every year, I'm going to have a different experience with it because there's so much depth and intricacies. And like one year maybe was focus on love other people, and the other year was love myself. So, you know, you can just allow the process to be what it's going to be and just be excited about it because it really is a gift. And this year, well, we won't go into this year yet, but it's just fun for me because it's like opening the present that no one can offer you. You know, it's just, it's yummy.
I I love that description with it too. And I was thinking, if any of you are a little bit new to this and kind of being a little bit more intuitive, one of my favorite tricks is to just get yourself listening to your heart. And so even if you just place your hand on your heart and close your eyes, then you can just feel into, you know, what's my word for 2018, right? Mm-hmm. And then just whatever word is arising, or you could just set that intention mm-hmm. with connecting with your heart and then allow it to show up like Kelly was describing, which is typically how it shows up for me now too, is it's just really like, okay, I'm ready to receive my 2018 word, and it just mm-hmm. comes. But it is like, you know, all of us know our next steps in life mm-hmm. in our hearts, right? For anything. So if you were like, you're growing your business and you're thinking, well, what should I do next? What's the most important priority? Your heart will always know. So you can use that same kind of an exercise to check in with your heart and with the divine and just say, what's my next step? And it will come pretty easily.
Yeah.
And I think that usually surprises people, that we think, because we're so in our heads, in our lives, in our world. And so like, but your heart really does always know. It's kind of a shortcut.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, hopefully that will get you guys thinking about words and that kind of a piece. One other thing that I like as we're building up to talking about how this has actually worked in our lives and in the most recent year, I was thinking that maybe we could talk for a minute about some of the experiences that can happen or some of the things that can unfold with you having a word set as your intention. Mm-hmm. And so one of the things that was coming top of mind for me, and I'll let you kind of be thinking as well, is that really this kind of, you think whenever you set your word that it's going to be a certain thing, and it's always a different thing. So, which is beautiful, because I love this. It's like with you describing your word of love, right? Well, it's almost like whatever our word is, the divine wants to kind of redefine it for ourselves. Like, well, what does love mean to you? And like, let's give you an experience of love so you can learn about it on an even deeper level. Mm-hmm. Right.
Yeah. And also don't be afraid when the onion starts to peel and you're like, wait, that wasn't what I signed up for. You know, because you're thinking one way, right? So can we talk about this year?
Yeah.
Okay. So this year, Quinn and I ironically chose a Sanskrit word. Mine was Kriya, which means mindfulness and mind, body, and spirit. And so at the beginning of the year, I envisioned that I would be all like meditating and super present. And I did that. And I hired like a guru of meditation. And I think I got like 15 books on mindfulness, and people were just, you know, sending me all this stuff, and I was, you know, practicing. And then I went to this yoga class and I broke my foot in a yoga pose. And, you know, it brought this awareness that, it was just ironic how it happened, but, it brought this awareness that maybe my mindfulness and my body part was going to change a little bit, you know, and I just had to stop trying to control how I wanted it to show up. Mm-hmm. And so then, you know, I did more meditation and less yoga and, you know, and just different things started happening. But by the end of the year, as I reflect back on what the year was like, what it ended up really being truthfully was being aware. It wasn't so much mindfulness, it was aware of like so much depth of things that maybe I've been ignoring or pushing aside, or, you know, the hidden parts that wanted to be revealed in my relationships or my business or whatever. And so, you know, I chose it, right? I chose mindfulness, and I can truly say that 2017 was an awakening of just shedding light on dark places and also some healing, for sure. Like lots of healing. 'Cause once you recognize what's in pain or what's been broken, then you can start to send love and light to it, right? You can start to focus on it. But if you're just like this, you know, I don't want to know, then you can't put focus on it. So for me, it wasn't exactly what I thought, you know, it's going into it, but I'm glad because now, I mean, I would have been sad if I continued to live like this ignorant way. And it's been a blessing for things to be revealed. That's all I can share at this time, but there you go.
Yeah. Well, I'm getting chills as I'm listening. I love hearing from you and from your heart, because, I think that's one of the greatest gifts that this gives to us, is that, it puts us in a greater level of surrender and trust with the divine, that even as you're having painful experiences, sometimes showing up, that you're like, okay, there's a lesson for this. There's something, like, you taught me this years ago, like, what's the gift in it, right? And so really looking at that and being able to unpack it in connection with your word, it just helps you have a greater connection to the gift than I think you would otherwise. Instead of like, oh, just this year was a tough year. Instead, you're looking back and you're thinking, man, I learned so much in this year of Kriya, right? Or this year of love, or this year of joy, or whatever it might be. And ultimately what you'll start to see is every year those lessons just refine you and bring you back closer to wholeness. And they help, it helps you to stay more in connection with your heart and soul than ever you thought was possible. So I love you sharing that. I think that 2017, by and large, was a pretty intense year for a lot of people in the world. And so I think everybody's going.
And think about just the natural disasters we experienced.
Oh my gosh.
You know, I was recently in Bali while the volcano was erupting, which is, you know, another interesting moment of my life. But, you know, as you do just look at the physical state of the world and the chaos of the world, I think our bodies, our minds, our spirits are trying to like, okay, how do we navigate this, right? And so choosing a word can help get you grounded and help you to recognize, wait, I can go with the flow on this a little bit better, because I'm not just going with where the world is. I can go and flow with anchor, right? Like, I'm grounded in my adaptability, you know?
Yes. Yeah, absolutely. I couldn't agree more. And so that's just making me think that I can share a little bit about my year too, which is also very unexpected, but good. So fun. So my word here again, as Kelly mentioned, was a Sanskrit word, which is Shakti. And for those of you that practice yoga or meditation, and have bumped into that one before, it's a big one too. It's basically like the word for the divine feminine. And it's also the word for, she's the life force, the creative divine life force. And so my intention with that word is, as it was coming to me, was just, I want to be more of a student and a servant of life. I want to be more connected to the divine, especially the divine feminine, to bring more wholeness in my system. And I want to be more full of life, right? Like, I want not just Shakti outside of me, of like, I see the trees and I see the flowers and everything's alive and vibrant, but I want to feel even more alive and vibrant within my own heart and soul, within my body even. And so this, I'm just keep looking at my word on the wall, but this year was big, because what happened, as sometimes does happen, is you get to experience the opposite of your word.
Yeah.
And so I had, this was a year of so much death, actually, like just, dying off of all sorts of, old paradigms, old connections, relationships that were not healthy. My own grandmother passed away that we had just forever with, which kind of ended this era of connection to a lot of pain and intensity in our world. She's great, but just we had a lot of hard times together. Mm-hmm. And then also I had this really kind of special moment in the beginning of the year, about May, where I was going to this yummy retreat that I thought was going to be so amazing. I was like, this is where I'm going to really connect into my Shakti energy, and I'm just going to lean into that aliveness. And so we had been invited to bring something to put on the altar that was going to be in the meditation and healing space. And so in my mind's eye, I saw this gorgeous nest, right? And so in my mind, I'm like, okay, I have a few days to get ready. There's no way I'm going to go find a nest right now. And so I'm just going to order one on Amazon. So I hopped on Amazon, got this, like, it was kind of cheesy, but it would work, you know, packed up this nest, took it on my trip. And then literally as we're in the restaurant right before going out to the retreat space, then I walked out the door. It had just rained. It was in the Midwest where it's like heavy, heavy rainfall sometimes. And walked out the door, and there on the cement was my nest, like the nest that I had seen right before that I knew, oh my gosh, this is the sign, this is for me. And it was just, I think, got heavy enough from the rain that it just fell perfectly down on the ground. And it was like amazing, right? And so I was so excited, and I thought, okay, I'm gonna take my nest and I'm gonna put it on this altar because I want to be with these, you know, these healing women and this, you know, all this divine feminine Shakti goddess kind of energy space, right? And so I put my nest there on the altar when I got there. And boy, oh boy, did I have such a powerful lesson of that my nest does not belong in anybody else's tree. And how I had kept
that's a good one.
Yeah. Profound. It's like life changing this year, because I had gone kind of fully like, okay, I'm just here and I'm coming and I'm in your nest or I'm in your tree and where are we going? Right. Instead of remaining so anchored into the divine connection that I have within me. Right. And this had been kind of a pattern in my world that I've kept, you know, are you my mother? Are you my mother? Are you my mother? Kind of a thing. All throughout the year, or I mean, through my life, right? And in trying to find that. And so I ended up having to leave the retreat early, and it was a really kind of traumatic exit, but I made sure and grabbed my nest before I left so that I could have it. And we actually still have it here. But as I fell into it, I researched what kind of bird made that nest, and it was a finch. And so I was reading about finches, and it was so neat because it was saying how finches don't fly in a straight line. Like finches, they dance through the air to get to their destination. Chills, right? Like, so this was such a powerful witness to me of like, Quinn, like your energy is meant to kind of dance to different places. And it's not, you know, and it's not meant to just go hardcore straight. And also like protect your nest and like bring it inward, be a better protector of your nest with your little birds, your kids at home and your husband. And like, let's guard that and recognize that this Shakti life force, creative energy, that it nests within, like that it comes from that anchoring and that connection within. And so that was a very, very powerful, like, if I could put any, like, that's what 2017 was. It was a, where do I put my nest? And then finding, oh,
it's a home.
I take care of it. Yeah. I take care of it in my own heart and home. And it's actually kind of ironic because our, my office, actually where I am right now, is in the basement, and right above it is my master bedroom. And so I was even seeing, like, we moved this year, and it felt like a very kind of Shakti creative move, and like bringing us into as you know, more connection with that nest and that just that sense of home, right? And so we moved, and I was just feeling so much gratitude over the past month as I was realizing, goodness, all of that Shakti life force, you know, creative fire energy, it's all just like connected to my marriage and like how that supports our home, as well as my work and how that's fueling everything. And it's helping me be more mindful that what I do in my marriage affects what I do in my business. What I do in my business affects my marriage and my family, and just the interconnectedness of it all. So it's been a massive year of just really learning what does aliveness really mean? And what does being connected to the divine and to our feminine ways of creating really mean? And there's been beautiful miracles and incredible opportunities come. I mean, one of those was Kelly and I had the crazy idea of like, we should go to Morocco this year. And neither of us had been. And to just be able to say, to be able to claim that, first of all, was a big deal for both of us, because it wasn't necessarily an easy thing for us to leave our homes and our families for that long of time to go all the way around the world, spend a week in Morocco. And, but to be able to claim it as, nope, we're going for creative inspiration, and we had very clear intentions, both of us, and to be able to allow that kind of experience to just unfold in such a fun, magic, adventure, wild way, and just to feel, so held within it was just so cool. So anyways, I've talked a lot, but what's going on for you, Miss Kelly? Well,
first of all, thanks for sharing such a, profound personal experience with everyone. You're so generous in helping us to all learn from your experiences, good and challenging. The growth is real. And that's what I love about your show, and what you invite people to do is, be authentic about your experiences, because we can all learn from each other, and I didn't know that piece about the nest, and it makes so much sense. I mean, it's so beautiful. And the thing that comes up for me is that we do have the truth within ourselves, and as much as we want to find the best coaches and we want to find the best, books and resources and conferences and retreats and all that, maybe be a little bit careful, everyone, because you can have your own, experience just very, very simply and personally with a journal. And so as you start to unfold, I mean, that's what I remember I said, I went and hired this guru meditation coach. I spent a ton of money, and honestly, I thought I was coaching him.
Oh my gosh.
For some of it.
Yeah.
Because I was like, I don't really feel like I'm getting what I wanted to get. And we had some good conversations, but I was like, I need to check in a little bit more before I just start hiring people. But I think that you will be guided to know how to allow the process of your theme, your year, your word, your intention to unfold. And so, the first thing that I would say is, get really clear with yourself and with your creator, and then, maybe get a journal that's for the word, for the year, and journal about it, or, maybe find a theme song for that. That we talked about, you can make a bracelet with the word on it. You can make a, a vision board. You can put it on your phone. And Quinn actually has a gift for everyone. Do you want to talk about that?
Yes. This is so fun. This is one of my favorite things to do every year, but it gets crazier every year because it gets even more popular. And this year I'm expecting it to be even crazier. But I wanted to let you guys know that if you're a part of my Soulful Business and Branding Facebook group, that I always love to do art for whatever your word of the year is. So you just type into the chat or to the comments on that thread about what your word is, and I'll make it and put in your art that you can print out. You can use it as your Facebook header. I mean, we've had people use them in all sorts of ways. It's a really fun way for you to anchor to your word. But also, I feel like this sense of community around our words is so, so helpful as well.
Yeah. Like, we're almost like championing each other as we start the new year. Like, go the year of creation,
Yes. Yes.
Go the year of whatever. And it makes it fun for me, because when I see the words that my friends choose, it helps me to bond with them in a new way, because I'm like, oh, that's what they're claiming. Like, that's the gifts that they want, Mm-hmm. And one of our favorite words that one of our friends did was the year of savor. Remember Michelle did that word?
Yes.
And that word has been on our minds, even though we didn't choose it. I don't think you ever chose it, did you, Quinn? No, I didn't either. But I loved that word so much that she chose that it kind of, just by associating with Michelle, it made me want to kind of claim it too,
Yeah.
So I think that as you link arms with your other friends and what their words are, then you get to, you know, by association, you know, claim a multitude of gifts, right? And we don't want to limit God, right? Like, you know, I'm not just going to choose one word, but that's maybe my initial focus. And then there's, you know, additional gifts that will come. So it's fun.
Well, and I think there's always little layers in the lessons too, like as far as, you know, one of my words a couple of years ago that had actually sparked the start of this show was joy. Yeah. I claimed a year of joy. And every year since, every one of the words, including Shakti, has taught me more about joy. So it's beautiful how the years start to build on each other as well.
True. And I wish, I'll have to go back through all my journals, but I wish that I did have almost a timeline of what year was each word. Such because it has been like, oh, I can't even remember. But I will tell you, the year of creation for me was monumental. And that was 2011. And I mean, that's when so many of the things that I was creating, and I'll never forget it, that when we moved into this furnished home and my office, I turned around after setting up my office, and there was the creation painted in a framed art piece on the wall. I'm like, my gosh. I mean, it was just all these things start to show up, you know, as you start to take notice, you know. And if you're opening yourself up to those lessons, you'll start to see everywhere you go. So this morning, can we talk about this year's words?
Yes.
Okay. So mine's kind of funny because, you know, God has a sense of humor, but I love it so much. So as I was connecting to it, I was thinking in my mind, oh, I want to be more physically active. I want to take more action in my business. And so I could feel like this movement, and I'm like, move is my word, M-O-V-E, right? Mm-hmm. And then as I'm thinking about it, I'm like, oh, that's going to be great. I'm going to take, you know, things are going to start changing. And then as I was sharing with someone else, I'm like, oh, this is so hilarious. Like, I'm actually physically moving a lot. Like, I was living in a temporary place, and then now we're living in another temporary place, and now we're moving into another temporary place because our house that we've been building for the last year and a half isn't quite done yet. It's a matter of weeks at this point. But we, like, right now we're staying in a friend's house while they're in Europe, and and so I'm just laughing because God's letting me to play in the word of move, right? And so then this morning, as I was doing my hair, I was like, oh, it's curl. It has some curl to it. Like, oh, there's movement to my hair. And then I noticed the earrings that I put on, and they have movement because they have, you know, like little like pieces that move. Mm-hmm. I'm like, wow, even subconsciously, I'm choosing movement because usually I just flat iron my hair and it's kind of, you know, straight, but I like to curl it too sometimes. But it just makes me smile because I'm allowing the process of this word move. I mean, we're not even in 2018 yet, but we're close, you know, a few days to already start to shift, you know, things within me. Mm-hmm. And to allow move to be additional lessons. So our family has been traveling and living in various nomadic places for 6.5 years. And we're at the very end of it. I don't even know how many places we've lived in, but the end of it is near, and we will physically move and set roots soon. And then my move word will have other layers, but right now we're still in it. Like, we are still in it. So I get to surrender it for the last remaining lessons.
Just so fun. Yes, I love it. I'm already seeing signs with my word as well, which I was like, do I share it? Do I not? Because it is such a like a heart word for me. But for the sake of just drawing you into the experience with me or connecting with that, I will share it very humbly, right? Mm-hmm. But my word that's come up is Shri, which is another Sanskrit word. But this is like, I guess, another level of abundance, but it's more like the abundance that you see in nature, right? The abundance of life. So it's like, when you look outside in the spring and all the trees are just bursting with blooms, right? That would be Shri. It's this auspiciousness, right? Mm-hmm. And one of the pieces of that is it comes from, of course, Hinduism and connection with that, with the goddess Lakshmi, which is the goddess of abundance. And she is, she bestows her Shri or her, you know, abundance upon those who are humble to receive it. And so there's this two-sided layer, and it just feels like a really sweet edge in my system that wants to be explored. And as far as like remaining grounded and rooted and connected to life and allowing that flowering to happen on a level that I haven't previously allowed. And it was mind blowing. Even just a week ago, Kelly and I were at a dinner with one of our new business partners. And I was just, my mind was blown after that night as I was realizing, you know, this Shri kind of aspect coming in. And I was feeling like, oh my gosh, with this business partner that we have, this could potentially double our business in 2018. But, you know, it really could. And there's so many other beautiful connections and aspects that are coming that it's almost like I want to put my hands out and be like, okay, no, that's enough. And instead the lesson keeps being, nope, open up to more. Nope, open up to more.
Well, and it's funny because as you become close to your friends and you feel their energy of what they want to claim, I actually just bought Quinn some really cute little tree earrings with like this tassel part on the bottom. And I was like, the tassel is like the roots and then the branches are like part of the earring. And as I gave it to her, I said, this is the year of like creation and abundance. And I really feel that for you. She's like, it is, you know, and she was already connecting to that, but I could feel that for her. Mm-hmm. And so that's the fun thing as you just connect with your friends and what they're doing and what they want to create, you will just, you know, unconsciously just like start to support each other and what this nurturing is of what this unfolding will be. And it's really special and it's sweet.
It is. It's like having this sacred connection with each other. Of being mm-hmm. able to see like, oh, how are you playing with God this year? Right? How are you growing with God?
And helping each other to see what the lessons are too, because sometimes we don't see them. Like I was saying, and you know, I didn't even connect that the move was actually my physical home moving. And I'm like, of course it is. I mean, that's been like the focus of my last year, you know, many years, but like sometimes we just don't see the obvious because we're just so in something else, you know?
Yeah.
And so I think it's good to shed light as we talk about our words, we talk about our experiences. And I'm glad that Quinn shared that with us because now we can help her to, you know, in little conversations or comments or whatever, just to notice like, hey, I see this happening for you, mm-hmm. you know, and I support you in this, you know, this desire and just take note of each other's gifts as they start to unfold or how we start to create in a more meaningful way, you know? And yeah, it's beautiful.
Yeah. And I think one of the key aspects, maybe why I was a little shy about it is because like some of our words are like, I think there's an element of thinking, well, everybody's going to think, I think I'm all that, or like, they're going to think I'm claiming that, but really like you're surrendering to whatever the word is supposed to be. Like it could have just as easily been another word, but this is what came really strongly. And so I love even that aspect of, as we look at each other's words or our own words, of really like surrendering humbly to the process of, and honoring and holding space for each other in yeah. those words too. It's so
well, and who is to say, you know, what God has in store for us,
it's so
you know? And I think it's fun because, you know, his gifts are always greater than the ones that we pick for ourselves.
Yeah.
And so just allowing that to really take shape is humbling and it is beautiful. And, you know, some words are culturally more grand than others, but it doesn't mean anything, you know, it's really the personal journey. So,
yeah. So this has been such a yummy conversation, Kelly, and just in closing, I would love if you would maybe share some of the, anything that's coming from your heart about co-creating with the divine and really living intentionally in that way, that you're such a voice for that. And I'd love for you to share, you know, whatever's coming up in that way that could support anybody listening and really anchoring in deeper to trust with that.
Okay. So what's coming up for me is to share two practices that I do that really help this concept of co-creating with God. And one of them is writing letters to God instead of just writing your journal or saying a prayer, which are both amazing and great, you know, grateful to have those practices too, actually writing out your prayers. And this could be a daily or weekly or whatever practice you want to do it. But I like to be really specific in as I write my prayers of, you know, giving thanks and asking questions and pondering things and just really writing out, because in my prayers, sometimes I'm not as focused or specific. And so in the practice of writing, I become more clear, which is a gift to myself. But then I also open the conversation with God to like, hey, teach me more about this, or I want to learn this thing, or I want to show you my absolute gratitude for the blessings that I've received. And then if you're ready for the next step, as you sign your name, then write, dear, your name, and just allow him to speak through you. And whatever words or promptings or feelings, just write them down. And this process of writing to and receiving from is so beautiful and it's so sacred that if you did this and you maybe had a specific journal for it, or my husband does it in his laptop, because then he can search, you know, them later easily. But for me, I love the pen and I love the process of connecting and writing and receiving that way. And the other, sorry, my voice is just dying. The other practice that I want to share real quick is just take a piece of paper. It can be a journal, a notebook, whatever, and just draw a line down the middle. And on the left, write me. And on the right, put God. And I just say my angel team or my A team. So God and my A team. And I say instead of to create, to-do list, I put to create list at the top. And on the left are the things that I have control over. Like I can get myself to the gym, or I can get on that call, or I can, you know, close that sale or whatever. Those are the things that I can do. And on the things on the right are the things that are out of my control that I want support with and help with. And they may be like, you know, helping someone to have an open heart about something, or maybe, you know, that my relative needs a job or someone needs healing or whatever. And as you start to partner in the things you can do and the things that you can't, but you want to have happen, that creation becomes really clear of, I'm taking care of this and God, please take care of this area of my life. And as you incorporate the letters and this practice of the creation list with your word and your intention, some beautiful things will start to happen. And sometimes I'll do these creation lists with goals, specific goals, like end of month goals or quarterly goals or relationship goals. And as you start to acknowledge heaven and how heaven's supporting you and say thank you and checking them off and making new lists, it becomes so sweet because you see that the creation process really is there. We just need to open our minds to getting more specific about the asking process. And as we do, then the receiving becomes so much more clear. And it's like you're really in flow, right? And that's one of Quinn's words, being in flow. And it's this tandem, like I'm doing this and you're doing this. And, you know, the dance piece that we've talked about too. I don't know. Those are just two things that are for me, like essential in my creation process. So I want to share that.
So powerful. I'm so grateful that you shared that. And I'm sure those of you listening after hearing that are excited to just go and get to work and have this epic 2018. And I know that it's possible. And Kelly and I are both sending our blessing and just cheering you on in that, and really wanting to affirm to you that you know, God, the divine, whatever flavor that takes, there is that force that loves and cares about you so much, that wants more for you than you even want for yourself, right? And so this practice that we're inviting you into and hoping that you'll receive and just go forward with is one that can absolutely support your greatest joy and your life unfolding and blooming in ways that you would never even guess, but that are so sweet and meaningful. So,
for everyone.
yes. Any last final thought as we close, Kelly?
No, I just echo the sentiments that Quinn has, that this can be really such a delicious, beautiful, sacred process. And we're just so excited for each of you, because we know that as you set this, you know, intention and move forward in the direction of your dreams, that you will start to experience some of your greatest moments, and you will feel the abundance of love from heaven, and you're going to just see it in other places too. It'll be so fun for you. And no matter if you're going through difficult times or challenging times, this is your place of joy, right? This is your place of, this is my gift. This is my special thing. And no one can ever take that away from you, no matter what's happening. So have a great time, and we love you.
Yes, thank you so much. And for those of you wanting to connect more deeply with Kelly over the next year, her Creating with God Facebook is powerful and a truly joyful, inspiring place that will support you in maintaining and continuing with this connection and living inspired. And in that way. So thank you so much, Kelly, for being on the show. It's been such a joy, and thank you to all of you listening. So excited to cheer you on and celebrate what the gifts are that 2018 has to bring to each of you. And so without further ado, with so much love, we'll talk to you later. Bye, guys.
Been listening to Joyful Living. If you haven't already done so, be sure to email me at quinn@joyfullivingmovement.com so I can send you our yummy Joyful Living welcome package filled with lots of awesomeness, including access to our private Joyful Living network. I read every email from my listeners and would love to hear from you. Also, be sure to leave a review on iTunes, and most importantly, have a joy-filled day.